In this video, I will show you how to activate the experimental branch through Steam, explain what you should consider and also how to disable any mods that may prevent the game from starting due to a new Timberborn version or update. Do you want to try, play or contribute to the development with feedback in the latest version in Timberborn? You can do that with the experimental branch. Some other games also have an experimental or beta branch. First, you should know that save files are separate for different branches in Timberborn, which means you won't lose your previous saves. However, you cannot load saves from one branch in another, and it's best not to do so. If you switch back to a different version later, you can still access your saves, but even with a regular update, old save files may not be compatible anymore. But who wants to play the old version anyway? You can find your save files in the Documents folder. Regular save files are in the Saves and Experimental saves are for the Experimental branch. I will now show you how to do it through Steam. Go to your library, right-click on Timberborn, Properties, Betas, and then choose Experimental accordingly. None is the default option. Once you've changed that, Steam will automatically adjust your game to the chosen version. When you want to play a full version that's released, you need to change it back to none. Now you can simply start a game and play in the chosen version. Now, regarding mods, if the game doesn't start due to the mods, regardless of the version, you can temporarily disable them. In newer versions, mod creators may need to update their mods for them to work. You can find more information about that on the official Discord server, found in the comments. To do that, right-click on Timberborn in Steam again, Properties, Local Files, Browse. Now you will be in the game's file path. Simply rename the BabinX folder, this will prevent the mods from loading and you can start the game easily. If you later want to reactivate the mods, simply remove the backup from the folder name. That's it. Don't forget to leave feedback and have a very great day. Cheers!